Hello everyone, thanks for joining the session. Here I'm going to present you the utility, content translation utility, which is being developed for one of our customers. Before going ahead, let me introduce myself. I'm Neha Gupta. I'm working as a technical consultant at RWS, a former SDL. I have been working as a consultant for different sites customers for around past 12 years. And during this tenure, I worked with the different versions of SDL, starting from R5.3 to the latest one, it's 9.5. So so now we can, let's talk about the utility, which what we have developed here. Yeah, a content translation utility. So here we have implemented a semi-automation flow for the translating of the content. So this utility is to export the source language folder content from the CME into a predefined CSV file. And then this CSV file can be used by any translation team to add their respective translated content. And then we are going to use the same CSV file to import the translated data into the CLI. So this is the high level overview of what this utility is all about. So basically why we have created this utility and what was the requirement we have got for this. So basically the requirement was there was some content within the CME and which needs to be translated. So when for the translation, you have a different translation team sits at somewhere else and they need the content for the translation. So how to do that? So that was a requirement wherein the content was there into the CMS, which needs to be out from the CMS so that some translation team can work on top of that to add their translated content. And then, the same translated data we can have, and if they also wanted that particular translated data to be imported back into the CMS. So how to achieve that? And that was the kind of a requirement we had received. So then we thought to design some custom utility or a kind of a small automation tool which can address this particular requirement. And the team can actually work on the respective translated source language data and they can actually provide the respective translated data and it can be added back into the CME as a component. So that was the requirement and how we address this solution. I mean, what kind of solution we had designed for this. So let's move forward this. The solution design. Yeah. So what we have done to address this solution, basically, we created a single utility. It's when we talk about export import from Tradeon CMS, basically it's a core service based solution which we had implemented. It's a single utility which gives you an user interface for exporting and importing both the data. So basically in this UI user interface, you will see a content management section wherein you can see attribute, wherein you need to, a user need to select the respective folder from which the content has to be exported. Yeah, but for different folders, for a folder, you can have multiple components and it is not to, like every time it is required that all the components within the folder has to have the same scheme. So suppose you have one folder, you have one component based on schema A, another component is based on schema B. So this particular tool is going to export the data irrespective of the schema. So you don't have to worry about the schema and whatever the schema components are there, it will, all the components, all the content components will be, content component data will be exported into the one predefined CSV file. So this CSV file is also designed in such a way wherein we can accommodate data of any schema, and it is not something wherein we have defined some specific fields of the schema and it will get exported the data only for a one schema. Yeah, so this is how the data of the export is actually loops through all the components there in the folder and then exports the data into the CSV file. So this is the export. And for the import part, how it is being added. So once I have the CSV file, I mean, now I have the exported data with me, what to do now? So the respective translation team, we can send that to CSV file to multiple translation team so that they can add the respective data into the CSV. And once we have that CSV file again, then we can use the same utility or the same user interface wherein we will see the import option so that we can import the same translated data into the CSV. So this utility, while importing, it will also localize the content in the target publication and adds the respective data into the components. So this is how this solution has been designed to address the requirement here. And now I will talk about the user journey here. So this is basically a small workflow for the export and import, which I'm going to explain. So you have a user will have the homepage of the utility, wherein they will click, they will see two options, whether they want to export or import. Once they click on the export button, you'll see one content management section. It is basically one item selector tool, which we have integrated. And as and when user expands, they will see the list of publications, and they can actually traverse through which folder actually they want to export. They just have to click on the respective folder. Once the folder is selected, they have to the ID will be displayed in one small text box, and just when they click on export button, it will actually loop through all the components. It will leaves all the component fields and exports the data into one CSV file. And then now the CSV file we can use to send this to translation team, maybe multiple translation team or single translation team. So we can use this data for the translation. And then once you have everything ready, user can still again go back to the homepage of the utility, select the respective option from here. And now here they need to choose the target publication, basically in which publication they actually want to import the translated data. So after you select the publication, now you need to select the translated CSV file which you had received from the respective translation team. As and when you click on the import button, it will again reads all the respective columns and the field component data. It will add each and every data into the Tridium component, and before updating it will also localize, updates the content, and then saves the data into the content CSV. Let me move to the next slides, wherein I have captured few screenshots, and we will also go for the demonstration after the presentation. So this is the basic few screenshots which I have captured. So it's a translation export import, wherein you will see two options. And as I mentioned, as and when you click on the content management, you can see all the lists here. You can traverse through the respective folder by clicking on the building blocks and respective content folders. So whichever folder you will select, ID will be displayed here, and then you can actually click on the export button, which will give you one CSV file. So yeah, this is the sample. This is just one CSV file format. So wherein you can see it's a component ID. So whatever the components would be there, all the component ID will be displayed. the component title and the website URL. So this website URL is nothing but a this particular on which page this particular component is being attached. So this can be used by the translation team. Maybe they want to see how the content looks like on the source language publication. So this can be used for that purpose. This will display nothing but a publication name, which would be your source publication name. And now this is the important one, which is the component field name. So here all the fields name are added in a row. So for how many fields you have within your component, it will loop through all and it will add data against each field. So it's a headline field has this data, subheading, now the content and the caption, any field, whatever the number of fields you have, it will line by line, it will add into the row. Now, this is the target language. So this is the two columns on which, basically this column mainly, on which the translation team is going to work. Basically, they will see, okay, this is a headline text and this is a source component data, source data, and now they need to add the respective translated data of this one. It could be anything. It could be, if it is a source language, Chinese, then you can have English, Japanese, any target language, you can have that. So this is how the CSV is being designed for this. And now, yeah, so once it is done, I mean, once the translation team adds everything here, then we can actually go back to our import tool and we can select, okay, this is my target publication. And once I will select my respective CSV file and click on the import button, it will actually localize the component into the target publication and also add the translated data into the folder from where the content was exported earlier at the time of the export. So this is how the utility works, and yeah, so is this utility also has few limitations, as it is well, it was developed to address a few specific requirements for the client. So as of now, this tool is not doing any of the publishing. It is basically will export some data and maybe some bulk data, and you want to import some bulk data, translated data into the CMS, you can use this tool. But it will not do any publishing as of now. It will also not going to export the data for the linked components. So suppose you have one component wherein you have attached a few linked components. So that particular linked component data is not going to be exported as a part of this tool. But yes, you can export and translate the linked component data separately. And also, as of now, this tool is not translating any of the images or the multimedia fields. But yes, these are just the limitations as for this tool. But anytime it can be extended and it can be used to address these limitations as well, and for any further improvements which would be there. So for now, this utility is taken care of the text field and the rich text fields. Yeah, so let's move to the demonstration part. Yeah. So this is my content manager, and let me just show you. I have created few components. Okay, this is my folder for which I'm going to export the data. So if you see here, there is some data already present into this particular component, and the same here as well. So let's export the data first, and I will show you the CSV file. Okay, now I'm here. Let me select this export. Yeah, so now I can see the content management section. Once I expand this, it will display all the publications, and when I select my, suppose my source publication is this example content English, I'll go back. So here you see, you can only see the building block section. and not the structure groups and the category keywords. So for now, I'm not displayed this. It is limited because we are going to select the folder only, export the content, and there will be no pages we are going to export as of now. This is the content and the folder. This is my export. So this is the export which I have added. Let me open the CSV file for you. So this is a CSV file wherein the two component data we have exported here. So you can see the component ID and the respective fields. This is the source publication from where we have exported the data. And this is my actual fields for which I have exported. And this is the source language data which I have. Now this can be used by the, now what I'll do, I will send this to maybe multiple translation team, so that they can add the respective language here. Suppose it could be Chinese, it could be Japanese, or any other language. And now what they need to do, translation team has to work on this data. They need to see, okay, what is the source language content here against this field. They need to add the respective translated data against each field of the CSV, into the CSV file. This is basically, once they will add this data, and we can actually go and see how to import this particular data. I have already created one sample file here, which I'm going to export. So before export, I would let's see how the component is there in our. So this is the my target publication where I'm going to export. Import the data. So this is my demo folder. So currently you can see the data is coming from the English publication, both the two components. And once I will import this, it will have the respective data. So let's see the before import, I will also show you my import file wherein I have already added few data. Yeah, so this is going to be same, only this section we are going to change. So I've added some data into the Chinese language. So against each field I have added, and same has to be done by the translation team as well. So this is my data here, and let me just go and import the same data. Yeah, I'll come here. Now I have the list of publication into the drop down where I need to select. Okay, this is my target publication. Now I will choose the file which I need to import, which has the translated data. Yeah, so let me just click on import. It will show you, okay, yeah, the content is being imported successfully. Now I'll go here and let me just refresh this. So now you have the local copy here. And as you open this component, you can see the translated data. So earlier it was all the source language data present here, but now with this tool, we have also added the translated data. Yes, so this is all about the utility. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you, everyone.
Yep. Thank you, Neha, for the great tool. I think what I see that we have this tool before, like we have a translation manager tool, but I think that is a more complex, like it also introduces workflows and it also does a lot of other things. But I think the customers who would like to have a very simple and easy to export it, and they want to look at it, that I think it's a great utility care tool. And and they can start extending it whatever is required later on. Yeah. So I think one question I saw that is that what are the languages can be supported by in this utility? I mean, for the translations, I guess, yeah.
I mean, there is no specific languages. You can use any language, you can add any language here to export the data, import the data.
Yeah, I guess that it depends on the what customer want to translate it, right? But yeah, how do you choose how do you choose that which language need to be translated? I think in your demo you showed that you want to translate this into the Chinese, correct? Mm-hmm. But how do you, if I want to change that Chinese or like I want to translate into the German, how do I, mm-hmm. do we have a facility at this moment? Is it possible to do that in the tool?
Yeah. Yes, I mean, it's basically the CSV file you have. So suppose you add the data into the German language, maybe. But it, mm-hmm. while importing, you just have to select the publication where, basically where you want to. Suppose you have a German publication, you just need to select the German publication and you can import the data.
You mean to say that you retrieve this information from the publication metadata? I mean, how do we know that which language need to be translated? Okay, German publication, meaning that mm-hmm. where that the language information you retrieve it.
No. I'm saying that in your CSV file, suppose I have the export with me and now someone is going to translate that data. So they will be adding, so we are going to tell them okay, which language they need to translate it. So while importing the data, I'm not going to check the publication, but yeah, obviously if I'm selecting a German publication or a Chinese publication, so based on whatever the selection you made into that tool, it will import the data into that particular publication.
Okay. Yep, got it. I think it's more like, if you want to read it from some publication metadata, I think it still should be possible to do that in the...
Yes, it is possible. It is possible. In the metadata, you have language and the region options. So that also...
You can read it from that.
Yes, that can be done.
Sure. I don't see any other questions. But it's good to see that, there's a... utility and someone want to use it. As I was recommending to other speakers also earlier, you should write a small blog about it and publish it so that it will be useful for the community. And if they need any details, you can always share with them. So
that's sure, great. Sure.
So I will strongly recommend to write a small blog about it and then publish it.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Thanks, Venu. I will definitely do that.